Well, hello everyone on this amazing, beautiful Monday morning for Facebook Live. I hope everyone had a great weekend, and I always have a good weekend, I'll tell you. You know, I mean, sometimes you go through some hard times and some trouble, and you know, but you always tend to bounce back up, you know, and God is always faithful to do that. So I am really thrilled you guys decided to join me today, and if you get on the Facebook Live, please let me know you're on here in the newsfeed below. I don't know if you're on here if you don't let me know on the newsfeed. So I have some really exciting, great news to talk to you guys about today, and I'm excited, so I'm going to take my time before I tell you. That way I can sort of wait on people to get on board with me today, and so we'll sort of wait for some of you guys and gals to get on today on the Facebook Live. And once again, I'm, you know, right now it's been a pretty good weekend, you know, this weekend, but right now outside it actually is a little rainy, a little dreary outside. Looks like it's freezing cold outside, which it is. You know, it's like welcome cold weather to the country. It's crazy. So, hey, good morning, Adam. Good morning, Jennifer. But I've got some good news to talk to you guys about today that I think will help you all out. Hey, good morning, Jane. That will help you guys out on this next season of your life. You know, as you guys know, on the Hot Off the Press Monthly Book Club, which a lot of you are members of, which I know you've probably already gotten your book by now, or you should be getting it any day now. So I'm really thrilled, you know, that for those of you who are on the program, I know it's these books are really helping you guys out. I had a testimony the other day, I think it was like Thursday, from a lady who said, you know, Jeremy, I you know, got on the program, and last month's book, you know, just really just totally blew me away. And I was responding through, you know, my customer service, and I said, you know, I said, definitely tell her, you know, I so appreciate that. It means a lot to me. And she was saying, she said, she told Tabitha, she said, you know, I don't think you realize just how much your books impacts, you know, people. And I'm like, well, thank you, I appreciate that, you know. And so ministered to me that I was able to minister to her on and through my books. And so, but the good news today I'm going to talk to you guys about today that is, I think it's going to be real exciting. And once again, for those of you who are on the program, I know people like Kimberly and Doug are on the program, which, by the way, hello, welcome, Kimberly. It's cold up there and it's cold on here, so I think you guys have sent us the cold weather. So you're welcome to take it back, Kimberly. Tell Doug I'm not happy with him and you guys because you're sending the cold weather to us. So take it back in Jesus' name, all right? We don't want it here in Alabama. But I'm excited because the new book just got launched last week, and you guys, like Kimberly and Doug, should be getting the book any day now. They shipped out last week, and so we're making them available to the public as of today. And the new book, are you ready for this? And the new book that is launched out for the month of January is, ta-da, The New Season Is Coming. And I am thrilled for you guys who are on the program to get this book today. If you're not on the program, I'm telling you, you're missing out. Right now, you have negative 43 degrees, Kimberly. Oh my goodness, man. Yeah, wow. You know, yeah, definitely keep it up there. Keep it up there. I don't want that, you know. Cold wind needs to stay up in Canada. But anyway, I'm freezing cold just thinking about that right now. You know, it's actually 40-something degrees here, actually, believe it or not. It's not negative, but it's 40 degrees Fahrenheit, Celsius, right? Is that right? Yeah. Anyway, here in Alabama. So anyway, here's a new book. The new season is coming, and this has a lot of details in it that I've been really praying about for a long time for a lot of people, because a lot of people have asked me in life coaching exactly things. And by the way, the life coaching has really just boomed recently. Like, we are really, really overloaded here with life coaching sessions. So if you guys want to do a session with me, you know, call in, get it on the books, order, you know, go online today and set up an appointment. I always tell people, you know, you don't get on the books until it is paid for. We tentatively put you on the books, but once we get payment, we actually hold it for you. So just let Patrick know, or some of the people on staff, if you guys want to do a session, because it's been very, very profitable for a lot of people this season for these life coaching sessions. But anyway, but I've been talking to people about the new seasons coming, basically in the life coaching sessions, about their season. And a lot of people ask me, so do we play a part in the new season of God? You know, seasons that we move into, do we play a role in it? And I said, absolutely, you play a role in it. One of the things I talk about within the new book, The New Season's Coming, which literally just came out last week, guys, is the fact that everything in the universe, okay, in God's kingdom, I should say, actually involves us. Everything does. God doesn't do anything without revealing his secrets to the prophets first. That's Old Testament. But New Testament, we're all sons and daughters of the Almighty God, which means we all have an ear to hear for those who want an ear to hear. We all have an eye to see for those who want to be able to press in and see. We're all pressing towards a mark. We're all, you know, equally, there's equality in the kingdom of God for people. So I wanted to bring out this book because people don't realize that a lot of times most people, and hear me closely, which I talk about this in the book, most people reside in the shadows of the old season, which means, you know, you're talking about putting new wine in old wineskins. That's what I consider the shadow effect. The shadow effect is when people tend to look into the shadows of the old, not understanding the wisdom of God and the discernment of God to know exactly when they have stepped out of it or when they need to step out of it, versus, you know, just having that sensitivity level, almost like the sons of Issachar, but having that sensitivity, discerning level to know where they are within the season. You know, it's nice to know, hey, I'm in the new season of God, but if you don't know the stages of the season, you'll never understand the power of the acorn and the oak tree, you know, which deals with the acorn being the beginning of the Genesis effect of your new season, and the oak tree is the full effect of the maturity of the ending state, you know, or towards the ending state of the season. And so a lot of people don't understand the shadowing effect is what they live in of the past because they don't know what to take over into the new season, and they don't know exactly if there's anything to take over. They don't know exactly, is there something new? Is there something old? You know, is there treasures of old I take over into the new season? Or is it all, you know, behold, I do a new thing. Is it all new? And so because of that, they stay in a place of really just, you know, of unfulfillment because they don't understand the seasons of God. And so, and the thing is though, you know, I was talking to someone the other day on our staff. I won't mention the person's name, but we were talking the other day on the phone. And, you know, a lot of times in the prophetic move, we get so caught up in the hocus pocus of everything and the oohs and the ahs of the prophetic movement that it sort of makes you a little loopy and sort of crazy minded, you know, and sort of a little flighty. And no offense against certain people, but some people get that sort of mentality. And the truth is, you know, there is a lot of authenticity in the prophetic move, and there's also authenticity within the seasons of God within our lives. And I think sometimes if you can leave out the flightiness of the season of God that God wants you to walk in, you'll understand through the power of discernment and through the wisdom of your own sensitivity levels in the spirit realm of those five, you know, spiritual senses God's given you to be able to understand and know what to maintain, but also know how to be able to sustain the power of your season, of knowing where you're in the season, to sustain that until your season's over. Are you with me? And so I think that's where people tend to get a little flighty because we tend to say, God's doing a new thing. God's doing a new thing. And I want to talk about that with certain people because I really, really, really love and respect the prophetic movement. But, you know, a lot of times when you hear these daily prophetic words and different things where every day tends to be a new season, you know, new this, new that, it's almost too repetitive and it gets sort of so redundant that it's like that place where the boy that cried wolf, where you really don't know, is every day a new season? Is every week a new season? You know, is every month a new season? And so because it's so redundant, you get sort of, how can I say, cold-hearted to the fact of the reality when you actually do step into a real new season of God, you know, and seasons sometimes of God can last, you know, a couple of years or maybe, you know, well, actually longer than a couple of years. And it can last anywhere between really a year to, you know, I don't know, 10 years. I mean, and so you have to really know the sensitivity level of what the season is there for, why you're in that season, and what's supposed to be happening, the definition of that season. Because if you don't, you'll always wonder, well, what season of God am I in? And it will throw your equilibrium off in the spirit to not understand exactly what's truly happening and where's your focus. You know, if you don't know what's going on, for example, if you look at a winter season in the natural, winter season guarantees us, for lack of better words, cold weather, unfortunately, you know, maybe some snow, leaves, you know, drop off in the fall before the winter season. So you pretty much know things are going to be perceived as looking as if it's sort of dead, but yet we also understand there's life within the roots. There's life within the ground, even though you look in the natural and see that it doesn't look lively. Are you with me? But you know an idea of what to project. You know there's going to be some cold weather. You know certain things will sort of look and give you that sort of deceptiveness that it's dead, but yet it's truly just alive. It's just sort of gone inwardly instead of outwardly with its leaves. And so you have to sort of really, you know what to expect in the seasons of the natural. Same situation in the spirit realm. If you don't understand the focus or a little bit of the definition of what the season holds for you, as opposed to going into it just blindfolded, just oblivious to it, you will never accomplish or achieve anything. There's no mastery to your season because you won't know what to focus on. You won't know what to look for. So when people say, oh, God's doing something, I just trust God and just, you know, go by the seat of your pants, you are being deceived because you can't go by that. You know, God God enforces and instructs us to know the power of knowledge to where we won't suffer, the power of vision to where we won't lack. And because of that, God instructs us to know the power of knowledge within every area of our lives, and to where the power of your wisdom and knowledge that is downloaded from the heavens and through your studies of God, and the power of the Holy Spirit working sort of simultaneously together, then you're going to have an understanding of the peace of God that even through the understanding of what you don't know, no biggie, because the peace will override those things you don't know, right? But there's still a focus. There's still a vision. There's still a definition. There's still an outline. You know, when wintertime comes, it gives you an outline of what to expect. When summertime comes, it gives you something to a little bit more expect. There's a little bit more hot weather. You can wear shorts. You might can go swimming. There's a lot of things within the within that sphere of influence of the season, the season you're in, the natural, that sort of guarantees you a little bit more of what to look for. So you can't go into seasons of God blindfolded either. You have to have an outline to say, I have an idea, a general idea of what to seek after from the definitions of God within the season. So I'm not going into this blindfolded. I have an idea of what the season is to be focused on, and a little bit more of an outline effect. And where's the details come in for your outline? You live them out through your journey. You live them out in your experiential aspects of the journey of that season, right? And that helps sort of to guide your sails of where God wants to take you within that season. And then plus you gain more definition. When you are experiencing the journey of your life and you dive into it more abundantly, you get more definition of your existence. Do you hear me? Listen to me. When you dive into the power of your experiential aspects of your journey, you gain more definition and you gain more empowerment, because you have more of a peace. You get more of a faith-based step what to do, because you have a little bit more of guidance from that compass in you that the Holy Spirit gives you, that sort of opens up the channel of instruction and definition as you seek, and God says you're going to be finding it. So you have to begin to dive into the experiential aspects of your journey, and through living life abundantly, you get more downloads and you have more of an understanding of what's happening. You have more of a definition. And when people say, is it true that you should love your life? I said, absolutely. I love my life. I love my journey. I'm not looking for the final finale. I'm looking for the journey of my now existence. My now existence holds the most revelatory unfolding and awakening that I can never escape unless I mentally escape from it. When I live in the now moment of my journey, I experience an unfolding of God that awakens in me something of a truth that I can take with me to the next moment and the next moment and the next moment. And that gains me more empowerment of knowledge and wisdom that holds me and guides me more through every second of the journey. Why? Because I'm learning to love my experience as opposed to some outcome. You know, I said this before, and I don't want to deviate from the book, but I'll tell you this before. When people tell me, I don't want to date, I just want the one. I want the one. I said, then you don't love your life. You can't tell me you love your life when you just want the husband, the wife, the job. I don't want to waste my time dating. I don't want to waste my time with resumes on jobs. Then you don't love the experiential journey of the abundance of life God gave you to have. Hello. Because every journey, every part, every aspect of your now moment of the experience is where your power lies. Your power lies in experience of your journey. And that is where people miss it a lot. Hey, Kelly. I just recognized Kelly's on here. Guys, Kelly Cantrell and I went to school together. This was so, wow, so long ago, Kelly. I'm so glad you're on here. It just caught me off guard here. But that's why God wants us to live the experiential aspects of our journey, because every now moment, there's a great awakening, a great unfolding of the next step, the next second, the next millisecond of God bringing this out. By the way, Kelly, definitely send me a direct message. I want to talk to you. I hadn't talked to you in a long time. But every moment is an awakening and unfolding of what God wants to reveal to you in the beauty of your life and the beauty of the moments and every moment God has for you. That's why he died, to give you life and life more abundantly, that you would learn to experience it. So back to my new book. This is like my 47th book out, guys. Do you know that? My 47th book out. And I'm always thrilled about it. So the new season is coming will help you to understand a little bit more of the season of God in which you're moving into, and have an idea how to be able to coach it, coach your own season, to have an idea of what to look for, of the signs of God, of the focus of where you're going, where you're headed, and what's going to happen in that season. So I want to encourage you guys. Let me give you some of the Look at my pretty face on here. And they had the definition here, you know, of the book. And here's a spine, here's a book. But anyway, but let me give you guys some definitions here of, or not definitions, but some of the chapter titles for you guys, all right? So how do you order? Tanya, I'm glad you asked that, my friend, and Eddie. If you go to the homepage of Identity Network, in fact, one of the team members should be on here with me. If you don't mind, can you go ahead and put the link to the actual page on the website that will take them to the page that gives them the book and the ebook to where they have an option, if you don't mind. Tabitha, Patrick, somebody, just send them to the page where they have the option of the ebook and the book, and just put the title in the newsfeed and below. I would so appreciate it so much. So the titles for the new season is coming of God for your life. Let me give you guys some titles here. Holds everything from Out of the Shadows. That's one of the best chapters I guarantee you'll ever in your life read. And thank you. There's the link right there. And it'll be one of the best chapters I promise you guys will ever read, because I'm talking about Out of the Shadows. If you don't know how to define the shadows of the old paradigm or of the old season you're coming out of, you'll never know. You'll never awaken to something new. Always remember this. A definition of something awakens you to know the structure of the thing that you're in. Okay, so whatever you awaken to gives you the structure of what that thing holds and the definition, and therefore you have an empowerment to work with it. Are you with me? And so when we're dealing with Out of the Shadows, we're dealing with, how do I know when I'm stuck in a rut of the old paradigm? How do I know when I'm stuck in a rut of an old season and I can't break out of it? How do I know that? What do I do? Well, Out of the Shadows, the chapter of Out of the Shadows will totally eradicate that for you. I'll teach you how to come out of the shadows. You know, think about it this way. Like I said before, thank you so much, Adam, on that. I appreciate that, brother. I tell you, I try to work my rear end off, man, to get these books out to people, because I love studying. I love reading. You're probably the same way. We are reading geeks. You know that, Adam? We're like, we love to study and read and evolve into great awakening and consciousness of God. But, you know, it's like sort of like when David put, I think in Psalm 23, you know, when he's talking about, out of the valley of the shadow of death, the thing that David was catching here that people don't realize, I say this all the time, and I'm going to give you a lot of examples in the Bible, where out of the shadow or the valley of the shadow, so there's a shadow and there's a valley. When you have a shadow of something, that means you've already come out of the thing, but you're only seeing the shadowing effect of the thing that you've already come out of. And if you don't understand that, then you can be deceived. Let me give you a great example for many of you. If you've gone through divorce, for example, and the residue or the shadowing effect follows with you, and you have to reprogram your brain. Let's say, for example, your husband left you, your wife left you. You have to restructure your brain to say, I'm not used to them not being in bed with me. I'm not used to them awaking with me in the morning. I'm not used to them what time they get in the shower or getting coffee with me. And so your paradigm is still stuck in the shadow, because it's no longer a real thing. Your spouse has already left you, right? But the shadowing effect or the paradigm is still lingering, and you have to, and you're having to, and those triggers are constantly going off in your mind saying, nope, you know, she's gone. Nope, he's gone. No, I'm used to waking up. I'm used to getting coffee with them. I'm used to seeing their face in the morning. So what do? You're having to come out of the shadow, because the reality has already been gone. The reality of the facts that they're gone has already passed. Now you're in the shadowing effect, and your mind is playing games with you because you're used to a paradigm. You're used to a structure. So now you're living in the shadow, but it's no longer the real thing. And you've got to know the difference. You've got to know the difference of the real thing versus the shadow that constantly plays a rut in your brain over and over again. And your brain, this is a known fact scientifically. I know I'm giving you guys a lot, but scientifically, it's a known fact. That the shadowing effect of the brain, okay, which is the trick or the paradigms of the brain that constantly that causes you to sort of hit the refresh button to say, is this real or is it a shadowing effect? Science lets you know that when you think something and you play it out in your mind literally has no clue if you're really living that out in the natural or if your mind is in the imagination world. It has no clue. It doesn't know if it's real. Or, you know, like the old, you know, commercial, is it Live or is it Memorex? For some of you young people, you won't know what I'm talking about. But you know, it doesn't know if you're playing it out or if you're just thinking it. Well, that's what the shadowing effect is of versus the reality. So one of the things here within the book of the chapter I talk about is out of the shadows. You've got to learn to come out of the shadows to know what is real now and no longer just the shadow or the reality of the old. Another chapter I have in here is, may it be unto me. Man, I love this chapter. I was like giddy when I was writing this chapter. May it be unto me is one of my favorite chapters about the new season. The new season of God, you have to come into the agreement. May it be unto me. Another chapter in here, the good, bad, and godly. Another chapter I love, belief versus perception. Belief and perception. Do they play a role together? And where are they? Where is the diversity of the belief versus perception? You got to know that if you're going to move into a new season of God. Another chapter in my new book is pain and process. Amen to the, can everybody say amen to that? Polly, hey, I'm glad you're on here. I'm glad you were able to join us today. So my new book is The New Season is Coming. And what I talk about, guys, is the shadow effect of knowing what is the old part of the old season God had you in versus the new season God is putting you in. And I want you to understand the difference to be able to move in the mind of Christ to say, you know what, Father, your word says, behold, I do a new thing. I want to move into the new processes. I want to awaken to the new season you have for me, God. And I'm going to teach you in this book how to be able to know the season and know how to have the wisdom of God by moving the mind of Christ to be able to process when and have discernment. You know, the Bible talks about the sons of Issachar and those discerning, that discernment that they have, the wisdom in the Spirit where they knew they could discern the times and the seasons. And I'm going to show you exactly how to move into that to know how to be able to know when an old season's dying and when the Genesis effect of something, a new beginning in God, is beginning to birth forth in your spirit. And by the way, Kimberly, I know you and Doug are talking about coming back to Canada. Let's definitely nail that down. My schedule this year is booking up fast for my travel. So I want to be able to, you know, help you guys out. As you guys know, I travel and speak all over the globe, and so I'm sort of getting back in the habit of doing that again. Another chapter also in the new season is coming is the expansion. I love this. Anytime you're in the Father, there's always an expandedness. Now, let me explain this to you guys to understand. When you're in the Father, when you're, you know, the Bible says in Him, you live, you move, you have your being. When you're in Christ, you know, you release gender. It's either male or female. So you come out of the place of understanding of even the holding that men put you in as a woman or a man, right? But then also, it says in Christ, you know, you live and move and have your being, which means you come into a beingness, an action. There's a structure of movement when you're in Christ. It's no longer about being still and stagnant. It's about movement in Christ. When you're in Christ, you move in vision. When you're in Christ, you accelerate into the things of God, because God says that not only behold, He does a new thing, but He's shifting you. He's shifting your awareness. He's shifting you into a place of expandedness where you go from glory to glory. And the book talks about that part of it, the aspects of the new season, of how the seasons expand for you as you begin to remain in Christ. Another one I love is respecting your season. I love this. You know, one of the things that God taught me years ago is learning to respect the old treasure the Bible talks about and the new thing God brings, respecting the season that you come out of. And you might say, well, Jeremy, I came out of a season of great pain. I created a great season of great sorrow, or maybe great torture. Let me tell you something. I've realized all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord. And not only that, but the power of Christ that moves in all the seasons of our lives, even through the pain and the suffering of our lives, there's always an awakening that jettisons us into something greater. And so let your pain be a process that is awakening you to something greater, awakening you and pushing you, you know, pressing towards the mark. Pressing towards the mark is not like, hey, I'm on the race, let's have fun. There's a pressing forth, like when you press grapes to make wine. There's a pressing forth that pushes you, and sometimes there's pain in the process. But you know what? This good about it is the pain brings an awakening to something greater that you didn't know before. And so when you learn to respect the seasons of God in your life, then you understand that God is here to shift you from glory to glory. And with every shifting, there's a great awakening. With every awakening, there's a great expansion. With every expansion, there's an awakening in consciousness, which means my mind awakens to see God bigger and broader within my life. That's a great thing of God. And I love the thing. Thank you so much, John, for saying that, brother. I appreciate that. You know, I love the things of the Father, because the Lord is here to show us that, you know what? He doesn't want to take you by surprise. He wants you to know that in my Son, you know, in Him, there's awakening. And if you ask, it'll be given. If you seek, you will find. If you knock, He guarantees you that there'll be an opening, an entrance, a portal of God, for lack of better words, where God awakens you into something greater about the beauty of your life. And to be honest with you, there's so much of a beauty inside of you that I want you to discover, because you are beautiful. And with every season of God, you will find that you'll go from glory to glory. You will find where the power of God will move in you and show you greater things that you know not of. So I want to encourage all of you guys. There's a link below. I want to encourage you, if you're on the Hot Off the Press Monthly Book Club, man, we had so many books go out last week. I was autographing them left and right. We have so many hundreds of people on all these programs we're on, and I'm so glad. But if you're not on the Hot Off the Press Monthly Book Club, go to the website right now, identitynetwork.net, which all of you guys know. And there's a link right here below that my team has put on there for you. And I want to help you guys out. Order the book today. You can order. All my books are on, you know, I have 47 books out. You can get all my books as hard copy, paperback books or ebooks. If you get the paperback book, I'm in my office today. I'd be glad to autograph it for you guys personally. I always know you can get all my books on our website. You can get them on iBooks. You can get them on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Books A Million. We have them through over 37 outlets across the globe, folks, you know. And my podcast, you know, you can get also on iTunes. You can podbean.com. I have a podcast, you guys. I come out with every Wednesday. I'd love for you guys to be part of it. It's called Thoughts Become Things. Get a part of that. But definitely get this book today. You guys really need to know when your season's coming and how you can move in God. And what, here's what's so great about God is God is so good. He wants to do things with us. Not just for us, but with us. He loves us that much to say, I want you to be like Adam, to walk with God in the cool of the day. In other words, I want you to walk with me and let's evolve and let's create this beautiful life together, Jeremy, because I'm in you and you're in me. And the new season of God, He wants you to be aware of what's happening in your season. So don't forget today, go right now, order the book. The new season's coming. You can call in my customer service as well to order the new book by me, or you can go online and order by this link, the ebook or the book. But I want every one of you guys to know how much I love you, how much God loves you. And thank you for being a part of our ministry on here. We've got a lot of good friends on here. So you guys have a blessed day, and I will talk to you guys soon. All right?